Ladies and gentlemen, the first lady of magic, Melinda.
Melinda Sachs was born March 6, 1965 in Tennessee. She is the daughter to Richard Sachs, who was a band leader, and to Bonnie Sachs, who was a dancer and show producer. As a young girl, Melinda became interested in magic after having a dream of being on stage doing illusions.
I had a dream when I was a very young girl that I was doing magic on stage, and I had this big black cape on, and I woke up the next morning and I told my mom all about it, and she just stared at me and she goes, "That is the most interesting idea I've ever heard, ever."
As a teenager, Melinda joined the Siegfried and Roy show as a dancer. At age 19, Melinda would later become the first female magician to have a show in Vegas and was billed as the First Lady of Magic. Melinda's first show was at the Bourbon Street Hotel and Casino.
My mom was the producer of the show. David did lights and sound and music. He'd even be on the drums every now and then. He did a multitude of things. Also, she was the producer, got all the people to come to the show, had to make all the ticket deals and all those things, and teach the choreography. My sister helped teach choreography also.
Magic for you, do you think? And didn't everybody tell you that as a woman you couldn't make it?
Yes, they did.
Everybody, including your coach.
Yes. I used to cry. I used to stand there and he'd come over and he'd work with me and we'd be in front of the mirror practicing magic and he'd say, "But there's never been a successful woman magician and they just can't do it." And he would leave and I would just cry for hours.
Really?
Yeah, and then I had a lot of...
Call him and tell him you're on the Oprah show today.
Yeah. But also at the same time, he was very supportive.
Uh-huh.
And I think that the whole magic thing really began from a dream. And that's how I really got interested in magic.
And, who influenced you?
I love Doug Henning, David uh-huh. Copperfield, Siegfried and Roy.
Mm-hmm.
I worked in their show for a while, dancing.
Really? Uh-huh. Mm-hmm.
And I just loved magic. But it came to me in a dream, and I really honestly feel in my heart that it was meant for me to go with this, and it was a very spiritual feeling.
Well, you cannot deny that, you know. When
That's
you have
right.
that in your heart, and it's a spiritual, you can't deny that at all.
Two shows a night for 8 years, six nights a week, with very little vacation time. So, we're talking hard work.
I had never seen a lady magician before. There were really no role models for me.
Later on, Melinda would take her show to other places, including Las Vegas Landmark Hotel and Casino, MGM Marina, Trump's Castle in Atlantic City, New Jersey, and she would later have her own theater called Melinda's Magical Mansion in Branson, Missouri during the late 90s. Gary Willett, who was a magician and television producer, chose Melinda to be on his television special called World's Greatest Magic on the NBC network in 1995, where she would perform her signature illusion called the Drill of Death.
This drill is designed to bore through an 8-foot concrete slab. It weighs over 8 tons.
You know, there's been jokes made about the sexual undertone of this illusion, but I never thought of it being phallic or weird or anything like that. And I have always felt like it was a spiritual aspect to make people feel happier and smile and feel good, and that's the gratification I get out of it.
Thank you.
could never forget those nights. The dreams, the fireflies.
In 1997, Gary Willett would also produce Melinda's own television special called Disney's Melinda, the First Lady of Magic. Melinda was named Magician of the Year in its Merlin Awards by the International Magician Society in 1998.
So it was very difficult in the beginning, and I would watch all the males and try to be like them, but you can't when you're a woman. So it took a while for me to find what my niche was with my show. I was very dramatic in the beginning, and I didn't speak much in my act, and I, you know, tried to come out and be very mysterious. And I feel like sometimes the women in the audience would feel a little uncomfortable. And I started drawing the people in more when I started talking. But that was the hardest thing for me to do, because I thought, well, once I open my mouth, I'm going to stick my foot right in there and people are going to hate me. And it was the exact opposite. Even if I, you know, messed up a little bit or whatever happened, when I was talking, the people got closer to me and more warm, and it just worked out perfectly.
You actually bring a child on stage, right?
Yes, I bring a little girl up on stage and I do some fun things with her. When I put the car illusion in, I bring a whole bunch of kids up on stage, or adults, depending. This show is a family show, and whether, you know, any age can watch the show.
Yeah! I'm all cut up. Jacqueline, can you touch my hand again? Still real?
Yes.
How about my toes? Are they still real?
What do you think?
Yes. All right, step aside and watch this. I think they call this a split personality.
In 2002, Melinda retired from Magic to focus on starting a family. After a decade hiatus, Melinda would return to Magic in 2012 to star in her brother David Sachs's show, V, the Ultimate Variety Show at the Planet Hollywood Resort.
The First Lady of Magic is back. You may have heard of her or even seen her act before. She was popular for years on the Las Vegas Strip, but then left to have a family. Now she's back in V, the variety show at Planet Hollywood. She's my entertainer profile today.
She wasn't only a Las Vegas star. She was known around the country and had a Disney special.
Please welcome Melinda, First Lady of Magic.
Melinda, the First Lady of Magic, has decided to bring back her act.
And now to see, you know, that people are still receiving what I'm doing, like, really well, makes me feel special.
Melinda performed up and down the Las Vegas Strip and had her own show at the Venetian in 2000.
It was my dream. I wasn't going to let go. Everybody kept telling me, you can't do it. You know, only boys can be magicians. And then I made all them disappear.
But Melinda eventually decided to have a family. She has two kids and lived out of state. She says her daughter's reaction, though, to her old Disney special inspired her to go back on stage.
She goes, Mommy, you have to go back to Las Vegas, so she called it, and wear big capes and Barbie hair.
Now, there's always something magical appearing in Vegas, and if it happens in Vegas, it happens on Extra.
The Strip's First Lady of Magic, reappearing in Vegas.
Ladies and gentlemen, Melinda!
Magician Melinda Sachs returns after a 10-year hiatus.
Thank you! Great to be back in Vegas.
starring as a featured act in a variety show produced by her brother, David.
Tell me about your magic tricks and what people could see you on stage doing.
David and I put the act together. He picked out some of the most dynamic illusions for me to do. I make girls appear and disappear.
Well, tell me what makes it the best show and what people and fans out there can expect when they're coming in to watch it.
They're the most dynamic acts that you could see in Las Vegas ever.
They're jugglers and magicians and comedians, and they're the best in the world at what they do.
The Ultimate Variety Show is now playing at the Miracle Mile Shops at Planet Hollywood.
This show is about connecting with an audience, just back to the basics of what Vegas was about.
Keep the magic alive.
Melinda, the First Lady of Magic. I actually had a dream that I was performing magic on stage. That dream must have come from seeing my family perform on stage. My mother was a dancer in the Folies Bergère and many shows here in Las Vegas. When I saw the shows, there was always magicians on the show. It inspired me so much to set out and become the First Lady of Magic. I started out at a very young age doing magic. I was like 20 years old. And I had performed magic for so many years and I just loved it so much. But when it came time to having a family, it was hard to have that balance of having the family. So I decided to stop for a while. I had no idea I would be coming back. It was like a dream come true to be able to have my family and then step back on the stage and let them see what their mom does. So if you really want to know who I am, I'm a spiritual, good loving person and a mom who loves to perform in front of fantastic audiences every night here at the V Theater. I cannot wait to perform for you. So much difference now that I'm back performing magic, because before in my life I had a little bit of fear. Now that I have my family and I feel so fulfilled, I have no fear of anything. I step out and the sky's the limit. It is.
Melinda Sachs will be remembered for not only being one of the most gorgeous women on the planet, but a woman who used magic to inspire millions to follow their dreams no matter how many obstacles are present. Believe in the magic of your dreams.
You have to fall down a little bit and you have to be down on yourself a little bit to get better. And if you think, oh, I'm there, you're in trouble, because there's going to be a night when things go chaotic. And with magic, that can happen. So you have to stay on the edge of your seat all the time. Follow your heart and do whatever you feel is right for you.